Bhopal gas tragedy. It was on 8th of December 2, 1984 when Bhopal died a million deaths. The chemical methyl isocyanate MIC that spilled out from Union Carbide India Limited's UCIL's pesticide factory turned the city into a vast gas chamber. People ran on the streets, vomiting and dying. The city ran out of cremation grounds. It was India's first and so far the only major industrial disaster. Till then, the governments had handled floods, cyclones, and even earthquakes. They had no clue how to respond in this case. The US-based multinational company Union Carbide Corporation UCC, which owned the plant through its subsidiary UCIL, did little help to deal with the human tragedy. 30 years later, there is no closure. Not because of what happened that fateful night, but because our response has been incompetent and callous. Bhopal was struck by two tragedies, the one that happened immediately and the other one that unfolded in the years that followed. The problem was nobody knew much about the toxin or its antidote. Within weeks of the accident, many claimed that the worst was over, that people were suffering from common ailments of the poor such as tuberculosis and anemia. But till date, nobody knows the antidote of MIC and how to treat patients exposed to the gas. The health burden is compounded by two more variables. One, children born after the disaster are also its victims because of the exposure to the deadly gas while they were in their mother's womb. Two, chemical waste remained dumped in and around the premises of UCIL factory, contaminating the water that people drink. Union Carbide used trade secrecy as a prerogative to withhold information on the exact composition of the leaked gases, though it was known that MIC, when reacts with water at high temperatures, could release as many as 300 highly toxic chemicals. Research was carried out only to check the toxicity of pure MIC, that also on animals. So, the treatment has been symptomatic. This is criminal negligence. In the first few days, there was evidence that people could be suffering from cyanide poisoning. Intravenous injections of sodium thiosulfate, an antidote, was found to be working on the patients. But soon, it was discontinued, may say, under pressure from UCC and its team of lawyers. People of Bhopal are suffering another legacy of UCIL, the factory used to manufacture three pesticides. 1. Carbaryl. Its trade name is 7. 2. Aldicarb. Trade name Temic. And a formulation of carbaryl and gamma hexachlorocyclohexene, GHCH, sold under the trade name Sevidol. For 15 years till the disaster, it dumped processed waste by product solvents, substandard products, waste from machinery, and polluted water at dump sites inside and outside the plant. Another 350 tons of waste has been kept in a leaking shed at the site. These wastes are still lying at the site, polluting the soil and groundwater. This second legacy, Bhopal disaster 2.0, now threatens even a larger number of people than the first one. Many of the chemicals degrade slowly and are likely to remain in the environment for hundreds of years. They will keep spreading unless they are taken out and the site is decontaminated. After effects of the survivors of Bhopal gas tragedy. Some 500,000 survivors suffered respiratory problems, eye irritation or blindness, and other maladies resulting from exposure to the toxic gas. Many were awarded compensation of a few hundred dollars. Investigations later established that the substandard operating and safety procedures at the unstaffed plant had led to the catastrophe. Similar tragedy in India. The Visakhapatnam gas leak, also referred to as the Visakh gas leak, was an industrial accident that occurred at the LG Polymers chemical plant in the RR Venkatapuram village of the Gopalapatnam neighborhood, located at the outskirts of Visakhapatnam, Andhra Pradesh, India, during the early morning of May 7, 2020. The leak was from one of the two chemical tanks that had been left unattended since March 2020 due to COVID-19 lockdown. The malfunctioning of the tank's refrigerating unit led to an increase in temperature, causing the liquid chemical suspected to be stearine to evaporate. This gas had killed 11 people and injured hundreds of others. Stearine is a chemical compound used to manufacture plastic and rubber. In another incident in June 2014 at Bhilai Steel Plant in Chhattisgarh's Durg district, 6 people were killed and over 40 injured in an accident of leakage in a methane gas pipeline at a water pump house. The 6 deceased were employees at the plant run by the state-owned SAIL, including 2 deputy managers. 2017 Delhi gas leak. Around 470 school children were hospitalized after inhaling poisonous fumes that spread due to a chemical leak at a container depot near 2 schools in the customs area of Taghlakabad depot. The students complained of irritation in eyes, breathlessness, nausea, and severe headache. How to prevent gas leak in your house? The first way to make sure that gas leaks are prevented is to inspect the appliances at your house on a regular basis. Make sure that they are still in good condition and check for wear and tear. Number 2. Check the signs. You will notice if there is a gas leak if you begin noticing the smell of gas in the air or in various areas of your house. Look for appliances that seem to have parts that look burnt or if they are accompanied with soot. A blue flame is also worth noting. 3. Have your gas lines monitored. Preventing gas leaks can be ensured by calling professionals to give you an accurate report about the state of your gas appliances. 4. Check your gas safety documents. It is a must to make sure that your appliances are installed in a proper manner and with official documents about whether they are safe to use. Established experts should be able to handle and install your appliances professionally to prevent any gas leaks in the future. If you detect a gas leak, turn off the gas supply. It is best to have a basic idea of the location and use of your gas meter before an actual emergency ever ensues. Make sure you know where it is. 6. Open the windows and shut off your electronic devices. If you suspect a gas leak, you should open the windows in order to prevent carbon monoxide poisoning. It is also recommended not to use electronic devices at your home during a potential gas leak to prevent creating a spark that could trigger a potential disaster. If you suspect a leak, you should call a professional immediately. 7. Do not smoke. Perhaps an obvious one, but especially if you are suspicious of any type of gas leak at your home, do not reach for your cigarettes and a lighter. 8. Do not flick light switches. Doing this may also cause a spark that can potentially lead to an explosion, so you should be careful of such things when you suspect the possibility of a gas leak. 9. Hire professionals. The best way to prevent a gas leak is to make sure that there are experts who are trained to fix problems such as gas leaks at your home. They are going to make sure that you and your family will not be risking yourselves if such a thing occurs. Also, as they inspect your home, they will be able to give you specific details on what to watch out for. Safety norm now. ISO 45001 is the world's international standard for occupational health and safety, issued to protect employees and visitors from work-related accidents and diseases. ISO 45001 certification was developed to mitigate any factors that can cause employees and businesses irreparable harm. Conclusion. So, what did we learn from Bhopal gas tragedy? The main lesson to be learned from the Bhopal gas disaster is about the dangers of the chemicals that we used every day. The most important lesson that has not been learned is how to prevent future leaks. Safety measures reduce the chances of leaks, but many leaks still occur all over the world. How could we have prevented the tragedy? Developing policies to ensure that industries operate in accordance with technical and safety standards and allocating resources for risk assessment and monitoring. Most of all, it's important to adhere to environmental norms. What message does Bhopal gas tragedy convey? It has been almost 36 years since the Bhopal disaster, but it is a reminder of how dangerous toxic chemicals can be to the environment. It is also important to remember that accidents like this can happen the more we continue to invest in toxic chemical plants for economic profits. Thank you.